Hello, my name is Ray Kelly, and I'm a practice principal for Micro Focus's Fortify division. And today we're going to be talking about how to set up WebInspect to scan a mobile application's backend API. We're going to be looking at what our actual target is, what it is we're attacking, and where we want to find the vulnerabilities. We're going to go through setting up the environment for your mobile device and WebInspect, and then we'll show you how this actually works in action. With WebInspect, what we're going to be targeting is the server side. When testing a mobile application, there's typically three areas. We're looking at the client, the network, and the server. And again, WebInspect is a web application scanner. So what it can do is help your testing as far as the backend server goes. And we're looking for things like injection flaws or bad session management. So things like SQL injection, cross-site scripting, those types of vulnerabilities are what we're looking for with your mobile backend. So we're going to talk about setting up the environment. So this one is pretty important to get all of this working properly. We're going to be going, essentially what we're doing is we're going to proxy the traffic from your mobile device into WebInspect, and then WebInspect will forward the traffic onto your backend API. So to do this, there's a couple things we need to do. You're going to need to either punch a hole through the Windows firewall for the port that you're going to be using. Usually that'll be 8080 or port 8888. Or you can just, for just the test, disable the Windows firewall just for the purposes of running your mobile test. You're going to also need your PC's external IP address. So normally that'll be a 192.168 type address or a 10 dot something address. So you'll just want to know what that is for when we get started. Then you'll need to configure your device to actually proxy its traffic over to the PC that we're running WebInspect on. So typically you'll go under the settings and your Wi-Fi connection, and in there set up the proxy address and port. And after that, all the traffic leaving your device will begin to get captured by WebInspect. Okay, so now within WebInspect, what we're going to do is start a guided scan. And what we're going to want to do is create a native mobile web service scan. And what we mean by native is that we're actually using a native application on the device. We're not using an HTML-based application. This will work for any native mobile application. And so that's what we're going to want to choose here. You'll want to pick exactly what it is we're testing on. And in this case, I'm using an Android emulator. And you can see here, these are your interfaces on your PC. And like I said, you're going to want to know which one you're using. In my case, I'm using the 10.0 interface. Next, we're going to want to install the WebInspect certificate. And what that lets us do is intercept SSL traffic and decrypt it. And so even if your application is coded properly and you're using SSL for communication to the back end, we'll be able to get into the middle of that so we can properly test all the inputs of your application. We'll move our emulator over here. And so to install the certificate, it informs you you'll want to use the browser and browse to this address. And so we'll go ahead and do that. And you can see here, would you like to install the root certificate? And we do, so we'll download it. Let's put in our pin here. You can name it whatever you like. Call it WebInspect. All right, so we have that certificate installed. So now we're good to go to test our application. For this demo, we'll be using an application called ForGoats, and or it's also called GoatDroid, and it's an OWASP application to help you learn how to test mobile applications for vulnerabilities. So it's a free download. You can get it from the OWASP website. So we're going to go down to run the application. You hit record to start recording the sessions. And for this application, it's GoatDroid and GoatDroid. And we'll log in. And you can see already we have some traffic. So here's the authenticate request. And as I said before, this is running over SSL, and since we installed the root certificate, we can actually see all the data in clear text here. And at this point, what you want to do is basically exercise the app. You want to get into as many entry points as you can, so WebInspect has a good threat surface to attack. So we'll just click on a few buttons here. And we'll leave a comment called WebInspect. That. And look at our friends list. So you get the idea. Basically, you want to go through as many screens as you can within the within the mobile application. So we're done here. So we're done browsing everything we needed to. So we'll hit stop here. We'll go to the next step. Now you can see that we actually recorded something else coming off of the device, and we don't want to test that. So you'll see different, you know, perhaps there'll be a browser open or something else running in the background that you don't want to test. So you want to make sure you don't enable that. But we do want to test this, which is what we're looking for. We know normally this will be your host, though, api.yourcompany.com and such. And all of that looks good. And you can see that WebInspect detected these RESTful endpoints here. So we do want to audit these as a RESTful endpoint. So we want to get You'll want to check all of the method calls that you want to test. We had our list friends, search users, view profile. So you'll just want to go through and check all the endpoints that you want. And then we're ready to go ahead and get started. So we'll say start scan. And here is our endpoint here. You can see in the tree all of the targets that we were assessing. This is a pretty small application, so the scan runs pretty fast. You can see that we did find cross-site scripting within the application. Can see the details here. And there was the actual attack that was sent against the backend API. And we have found some mediums also, some lows. And our scan is now complete. So we were able to test our backend API fairly easily and fairly quickly as well to look for those vulnerabilities. And that is the end of the demo. For more information, you can visit us at Fortify on Demand on the Micro Focus website and get more information about testing your dynamic applications as well as mobile applications. Thank you and have a good day.